Today I'm going to ask you, would you take a pill if it could cure your autism? That's a good question, isn't it? And I know the answer is different for everybody, and absolutely it's going to depend on your own personal experience being on the spectrum. Today I'm going to share some information out of a new study that shows promising results from a medication that's already approved and being used in other conditions. It's showing promising results to lessen the symptoms of autism. So we're going to talk about that today. I'm Dr. Christine Bradstreet. I'm a retired chiropractor. I have ADD and I'm on the autism spectrum, and it is my job and my passion to bring information to you to help you have more success in your life, in your health, in your physical health, your mental health, your spiritual health, more success on the spectrum. So thank you for being here. Before I go any farther, please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell so you'll be notified when new videos drop and when I go live. And remember, when you subscribe to a YouTube channel, it's like supporting a small business, but it doesn't cost you any money. So thank you. Thank you for subscribing and for being here. So what am I talking about? A pill that might cure autism? Some of the symptoms of autism stem from a gene mutation. Now, there are many theories and many layers of things that contribute to the development of autism, but one major point is a gene mutation, a mutation in the gene MYT1L. Don't ask me to repeat that too many times, please. So, what that stands for is myelin transcription factor 1. Let me try to explain this in lay terms. It triggers the production of a protein that is crucial in the production of nerve cells. Now, they have found when they turn off this gene in both nerve cells of mice and of humans, that when that happens, the nerve cells sort of forget that they're nervous system cells, and they start to take on some of the characteristics that we commonly see in heart muscle cells. Basically, what is happening, there's something called a sodium channel in the cell wall, the membrane that surrounds a cell, that allows sodium, it regulates sodium in and out of a nerve cell. And when the gene is turned off, the nerve cells become hyperactive in this method of physiology. And then that is what is leading to some of the symptoms of autism, including some of the social difficulties that people with autism have. Now, drugs already exist on the market that help to block these sodium channels. A common one is used in epilepsy. It's called Lamictal. Now, I'm going to look away from the camera for just a minute because I'm going to read a quote to you out of the scientific journal where I learned about this. Apparently, drug treatment in adulthood can alleviate brain cell dysfunction and thus counteract behavior abnormalities typical of autism, even after the absence of MYT1L has already impaired brain development during developmental phase of the organism. So, what that means is even adults would benefit from taking this drug in theory. Now, would you take a drug if it, quote, cured your autism? Again, I suppose that really is individual, depending on how much of an impact the autism spectrum has on your quality of life. And does that mean that you'd be giving up some of the things that you love about being on the autism spectrum? No right or wrong answer to that one. But I did find it fascinating that they're beginning to study this drug, Lamictal, and how it might help people on the autism spectrum. So far, these preliminary studies have been done in mice, but they are forming clinical trials right now. I'll leave a few links in the video description or at the top of the comments where you can actually read the journal article, read the study for yourself to learn more about it. In the meantime, I wish you success on the spectrum. Please stop by to see some of the other videos, and please be sure to subscribe. Bye-bye.